Hello there, my RPG lovers, and welcome to another video. Today we're gonna talk about the stats in Outworld, and I'll try to explain all of them real quick with some clear examples. Some of them can be a bit confusing, but I assure you that all of them are pretty straightforward and easy to understand. I'm going to use the Outworld wiki for some info, but I'll also have a lot of tips and info based on my own experience. Be sure to press the thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel. We're getting really close to 10k subs, so please help me reach that mark, it really means a lot. Anyway, let's start the video. We're starting off with offensive stats. We got physical, impact, attack speed, and damage bonuses. Physical is obviously the most common damage type, and most non-magical sources are physical. Your total physical damage is the first icon under the attack section. This number will include all the bonuses from weapons and skills as well, so don't think that this stat right here only shows the damage from your weapon. Physical damage is associated with these status effects: pain, bleeding, extreme bleeding, confusion, discipline, cripple, and physical attack up. This means that different weapons and skills can have one or more effects mentioned above that you can apply to enemies by dealing physical damage, and your character can also be affected by the same effects. Every enemy in the game have some sort of physical resistance, but only enemies like Eternals and Ghosts are highly resistant to physical damage. Moving on to second attack attribute called Impact. Every weapon in Outworld has Impact that determines how much damage is dealt to the stability bar. Reaching 50% of the stability bar makes the character stagger, while 100% damage leads to a fall. Your character and every NPC in the game will have this stability bar that will get affected by Impact. Heavy armors and especially shields will offer you huge impact resistance. It's important to understand though that shields will only give you that impact resistance while you block. Your stability bar won't get that additional impact resistance from your shield if you are not holding the block. Larger enemies will stay longer on the ground after being knocked down to account for their greater stability. The highest impact damage dealing weapons are one-handed and two-handed maces, but at the cost of speed. Moving on to the next offensive attribute, and that's the attack speed. Every weapon has the attack speed number, which will determine how fast is a weapon swung. It's really simple actually, the higher the number, the faster the attacks. One-handed swords usually have the fastest attack, but this will also depend on the weapon quality. I have a few quick examples for you here, where you can see the difference in speed between some weapons. 0.1 difference in speed is actually quite noticeable, as you can hopefully see here. I personally like to use weapons with at least one or more speed, but this is highly subjective since slower weapons will usually do more damage at higher impact. So you can choose whatever floats your boat. There is just a ton of weapons in this game with different stats, so comparing them all would be crazy, but I might do it. We're moving on to defensive stats. We'll start off with protection. This stat can be found on heavier armors, and it will reduce the physical damage you take by a flat amount. So let's say if you have 10 protection and you get hit by a weapon that deals 20 damage, you'll suffer 10 points of damage in total. This is some monkey level math right here, but you get the picture. Like I said, heavier armors will grant you higher protection at the expense of speed. The second defensive stat is resistances. This stat will also reduce the physical damage that you take, but it will work as percentage damage reduction. It's much more common than the protection stat, and usually every type of armor will have some resistances. The naming could be better because just by mentioning resistances, my mind usually flows to elemental resistances. The next stat in defensive section is impact resistance, and we already covered this, I could just add a couple of stuff that I didn't mention above. Your stability bar is located here, and you can also see the enemy bar below their health. When you or your enemy starts blocking, the bar will turn yellow, which means that you'll have more stability from blocking, especially if you're using a shield. So, like I mentioned above, the stability from shield will only be added while you're holding the block and when your stability bar turns yellow with a shield icon. Now we're gonna talk about elemental damage types, resistances, and associated status effects. Starting off with fire element. You will find weapons with fire damage, and most of them will also apply the burning effect, which will act as a fire dot. Not all fire weapons will have the burning effect, but you can use items such as fire rags or fire varnish to add the burning status effect on your weapons. Certain enemies will also do fire damage to your character, and you can also suffer the burning status effect. The quickest way of getting rid of the burning effect is by drinking water from your water skin. Tumor status effects associated with fire damage are Warm Boon and Burn. Warm Boon is a buff that will increase your fire damage and fire resist, while Burn is totally opposite and it will decrease your fire damage and fire resist. Notable fire enemies are Obsidian Elementals and Burning Man, which also means that they have high fire resistance. Having a fire weapon with you will almost always be a good choice for good damage output. The next on our list is Frost Elemental effect. Apart from the slowdown effect that is associated with Frost Element, there is not much difference between Fire and Frost. In my opinion, the slowdown effect is more annoying than burning when you get affected by it. Of course, you're gonna be able to find weapons that do frost damage, and you have enemies that have high frost resistances like Wendigos and Ice Witches. Choosing between Fire and Frost Element will come down to personal preferences or just by your luck with RNG loot. If none of those elements suits your style, the Eternal effect might be your choice. Unlike Fire and Frost, Eternal doesn't have a dot associated effect, but it will be essential when fighting undead enemies such as ghosts. Your physical damage will almost be completely unusable against undead enemies, while having Eternal elemental effect on your weapons will just shred them. Not only undead, this element will also do quite a bit of damage to almost all enemies in the game, because to my knowledge there are no NPCs with Eternal resistance, making this element a really good choice in every combat situation. The next elemental effect is Lightning. Just like Eternal, Lightning doesn't have a dot status effect, but what makes this element a good choice is quantity of weapons that will come with this element. There are ton of weapons with Lightning element effect, and without a doubt you'll find quite a few while you play. Doomed effect is associated with Lightning, and you can also apply Lightning damage to your weapons with Bolt Rags and Bolt Varnish. Notable enemies that have high lightning resistance and damage are Lightmender, Golden Minions, Golden Spectre and Pistol Shrimp. And last, but certainly not least, we have DK element. This is probably the best effect that you can have on your weapon, simply because it ignores all the armor on your enemies. Poison and Extreme Poison are effects associated with DK damage. Just like Eternal, there are a lot of weapons that will come with DK damage and associated DK effects such as Poison. It's a really good option for beginners and in general. Just remember, enemies that do DK and Poison damage to you will also have a high resistance to this effect, and there are actually quite a few enemy types that deal DK and Poison damage. Curse is also an effect that is associated to DK damage, making this effect even harder to deal with if you don't have enough DK resistance. That will cover all the element effects in Outworld. In my opinion, all these effects are useful depending on the situation. The rest of the stats that I didn't cover are Move Speed, Stamina Cost, and Mana Cost. Move Speed determines how fast your character is moving. Surprise, surprise. Things that will affect this stat are your pockets, your backpack, your armor, and some debuffs like Slowdown. You can increase your movement speed with items and skills. For example, here I only have one piece from the Master Trader set, which gives you a really nice speed boost. You will also see how weight of the pockets and the bag will affect the movement speed of this character. Stamina cost is really important for every melee build in the game. In Outworld, there is a ton of gear for you to find, buy or craft, and a lot of the pieces will give you minus stamina cost. Reducing the cost of stamina will allow you to attack, dodge and run more. You can also get nice buffs that will reduce the stamina cost, like when you sleep at your house, the inn, or some advanced tent. Mana cost works pretty much the same. Certain gear will give you minus mana cost, which will allow you to cast spells more easily. This gives you a couple of options when you choose to use spells, since you can decide to not sacrifice a lot of health and stamina for mana, and go for the mana reduction gear, or go with gear that gives you no minus mana cost, but invest more points in your mana pool. The last two pretty straightforward stats are Hot Weather Resistance and Cold Weather Resistance. Heavy gear will give you penalties to Hot Weather Resistance, and light gear will do the opposite. It's good to know that you can still wear the armor of your choice anywhere if you consume some useful food that will give you resistances to these two stats, or you can use some items like Ice Flame Torch in the desert to prevent the heat. And that will be all for this video. I hope you found it useful, and if you did, be sure to subscribe to the channel for more content and press the thumbs up button. This channel is based around RPGs in general, so if you're into those kind of games, you'll probably find something for you. I have to give special thanks to my patrons. Thanks a lot for supporting this channel in the long run. And if you as well want to support me there, I'll leave all the links in the description. See ya in the next one.